This past Shabbos became, for myself personally, I have to thank the Rabbeinu Shalom, what I called the Kala Meshuleshes, the tripled Kala. First of all, we all became a Kala. By Matan Torah, we became a Kala because Rabbeinu Shalom is a Chassan. So interesting that the wedding is built so much based on Matan Torah. If you look at a wedding with the fires going down, leading the Chassan actually greeting the Kala. Underneath the chuppah is, so to speak, the mountain that was being hovered on top of Klal Yisrael. And there's many, many mitzvah Hashem we'll speak about this more in the future. So Shabbos became the Shabbos Kala. Of course, right now we're in Sheva Brachas with the Rabbeinu Shalom. That's number one. And number two is the Rabbeinu Shem gave me the schus and the schia to have see my daughter as a kala. She became a kala. And mitzvah Hashem, next week, mitzvah Shabbos, we're doing a vort. I consider everyone here that joins me on the travels and everything else as family. So everyone, if they're in Muncie, it'll be a schus to see everyone. But obviously, no one should schlep to come and say, just so you could also send a mazel tov to next mitzvah Shabbos. That was number two, triple kala, second kala. And third kala is this Thursday night, I'm zeicha with my chavrusa to make a siyum on Maseches Yerushalmi. To make a siyum on Maseches Yerushalmi is also an incredible gift. So I thank, and there's no words for me to give the Rabbeinu Shem other than to publicize that all this, of course, is miracles, and to connect this to something so precious that one of the listeners, other known as, his name is Talisman, someone that's been giving out talisim and everything, and is an amazing, amazing inspiration. You can go online, you could see if you need any information all over the world, anyone that needs a talis, tzitzis, so once we become the mitzvah of tzitzis. So my dear friend reminded me of something that he saw last year. Last year, I think it was last year, 2 years ago, we were discussing the idea as Rosh Chodesh Adar approaches, we're getting close, Baruch Hashem. Purim is in the air. This coming Shabbos, of course, is Shabbos Mevorachim Adar. What's the theme? What permeates the entire month of Adar and it leads up to Purim itself? So I explained, based actually on the Lubavitcher Rebbe, who said that 60, if it's a leap year, is 60 is Mevatel, all sadness, meaning 60 days of Rosh Chodesh Adar, usually something is batel and shishim, if I'm not mistaken. The Maseches Chulin says also one opinion, 30. So here, now that we're almost beginning 30 days before Purim, there's an incredible opportunity to destroy any ounce of sadness, but so what else did we add? We added and we said that how do we build? How do we get to Purim? How do we be Mekayim, of course, which we'll discuss more when it says, Mishnichnas of the Marbim Besimcha. What does that mean? How do we Marbim Besimcha? And we explained that joy, that happiness has a definition. Happiness is the emotional pleasure you experience when you focus on what you have. And wow, is it this powerful and powerful definition. This I always get from definitions from Noach Weinberg, Zichrono Livracha. When you have a definition, it's shaykh to fulfill it. It's shaykh to be able to get there. And here's an amazing thing. You know, when a person has a simcha, so to have a simcha, what's the one thing that the Yetzirah, the Baal Dover, the Satan will do more than anything else is he'll take away from the simcha. The worries about the people, about the event, about the money, about who to invite, who not to invite, to make sure that you want it dafka the way you want it. You know how many arguments I've seen outside of myself. So the Rabbeinu Shalom, I only could be able to thank the Rabbeinu Shalom and share my simcha with everyone else, and especially the Siyam. Anyone that is listening, really, I always feel like the mishpacha. So I want to tell you the following. So this talisman reminded me. So I said, what's the best mishlachmanis that I could get from someone? Is if someone starts now, or Rosh Chodesh Adar, you could start now, it's even better. Making a list of all the things we have to be thankful for, because that's how we build happy muscles. Happiness muscles are built by focusing on what we have, and then we learn and we teach ourselves and our kids and everyone around us that no matter what, we could focus on the positive things in life. And there's an amazing story, Bli Neda, we'll discuss this tomorrow. But in the meantime, Mishloach Manos this year has to be from everyone a list of all the things we appreciate in life and how much happiness muscles we were able to develop this year more than any other year. Have an amazing week.